Welcome to a new video. Herbalife is a company dedicated to the production and marketing of nutritional supplements of American origin. With just over 3 decades since its foundation, today it is already present in almost 100 countries globally. Today, I'm going to present you secrets, curiosities, and some of the darkest cases of this transnational company. In this video, I will mention the secrets of Herbalife. Let's begin. Its history takes back to 1980, when Mark Hughes created the company after his mother's tragic death at 36 years of age from an overdose of prescription pills for weight loss. It was then that Mark set out to help people with a combination of herbs and weight management technology. Mark's grandmother was his first client, who lost 11 kilograms in a month. Later, he decided to try this product himself and lost 7 kilograms in 2.5 weeks. Sometime later, his grandmother got Mark's clientele, and they got to know him by word of mouth, until he personally began to deliver his product with his car. Finally, in 2000, Mark's wife found him lying in bed with pills and alcohol, overdosed just like his mother. Today, Herbalife operates in approximately 90 countries such as Canada, Australia, the United Kingdom, New Zealand, Mexico, Brazil, among others. In addition, at the end of 2012, it earned more than $400 million. It also has approximately 7,400 employees worldwide and more than 3 million distributors worldwide. Lastly, the company sponsors more than 250 athletes, teams, and events around the world, where they presume to be the official nutrition advisors of Cristiano Ronaldo, the University of Mexico club, Paco Raptor, Los Borregos Salvajes, and Lionel Messi. Herbalife has approximately 180 products, of which the first was the Formula One Nutrition Shake Mix. Sometime later, more products were created for specific parts of the body, such as protein powder, fiber powder, powder drinks, powder to mix in smoothies, tablets, bars with protein, and Herbalife skin. In general, these products consist of vitamins, minerals, micronutrients, and phytonutrients. In 2011, Herbalife 24, a line of nutrition for athletes who stay active 24 hours a day, was launched, claiming that the formula does not consist of medication. The line consists of 7 products that can be used as needed. As an extra fact, 3 Herbalife products were banned in Colombia since the National Institute for the Surveillance of Medicines and Foods in that country assured that the substances that make up the products are drugs and not food. In 1994, Mark created the Herbalife Family Foundation to raise donations and improve the lives of some children, promoting good nutrition for those at risk in orphanages, community centers, and hospitals in more than 50 countries. The foundation also provides financial assistance in the event of natural disasters. For example, in a shelter located at the marginal areas of Los Angeles, more than 700,000 plates of food are served to homeless men, women, and children, with the help of Herbalife employees, who they voluntarily help prepare and serve protein shakes for breakfast for those most in need. In 2009, a study was conducted on Herbalife products, which focused on the knowing if the company's supplements cause liver damage. The reason for the study was because a small percentage of people who had the symptoms of liver poisoning around the world say that they regularly consume Herbalife products. The place of the study was in Argentina by Dr. Hugo Tano. In his study, he included 2 patients as evidence. Among the symptoms they presented are allergic reactions, respiratory failure, dark urine, tiredness, among other symptoms. Also in the study, explained that these symptoms are caused by liver problems, such as hepatitis, liver poisoning, or liver failure. Finally, Dr. Hugo Tano made it clear that Herbalife products are not bad for the liver. However, there are patients that cannot ingest such products because their liver does not allow it. As an extra piece of information, the Ministry of Health and Consumption in Spain also reported cases of liver toxicity in Herbalife consumers. Therefore, it was recommended not to use the product. If you want to read some other studies on the effects of Herbalife on the liver, you can find the links in the description. Now you will know the darkest cases of this transnational nutrition company. Let's begin. The first case occurred a few months ago in Central North America. In July 15, 2016, Herbalife faced a $1 million lawsuit in the US for cheating their consumers and sellers of their products by promising sums of money that they would never make. A few months ago, the Federal Competition Commission filed a lawsuit against Herbalife for the use of the pyramid scheme. This scheme consists of the sellers recommending customers to sell their products in order to give benefits to the original sellers. This type of economy is prohibited in different countries of the world, among which are the USA. In his defense, Herbalife President and CEO Michael Johnson explained that the out-of-court settlements are proof that Herbalife is a solid business and that it proves the ability to move forward successfully. For years, Herbalife has received complaints from vendors and consumers that they have made no profit from the pyramid system. Bill Ackman is a hedge fund manager from the USA. Since 2012, Mr. Ackman made his disagreement against Herbalife public, accusing of pyramid fraud, which consists of a person or a company offering the public an investment opportunity, but in the end, everything they invested is lost. Given this, the Federal Competition Commission did not take into account Bill's accusations. However, complaints from customers and vendors were taken into account. Ultimately, Herbalife had to pay $200 million lawsuit for offering benefits to its customers that will never be reached. Lastly, Eddie Ramirez, president of the Federal Competition Commission, explained in a statement that this decision caused Herbalife to restructure its system so that sellers are rewarded for what they sell and not for the people they recruit. If you want to read the original information, I'll leave you a direct link in the description. The second case occurred a couple of years ago in the west of the US. In mid-2011, one of the founders and bestsellers of the Herbalife company, named John Peterson, originally from Colorado in the United States, committed suicide in his own home, possibly due to financial problems. Since 1980, Mr. Peterson began his participation in the Herbalife company, and on 10 occasions was named Distributor of the Year. In addition, it was part of the Circle of Founders, and in 2012, it is estimated that its sales were approximately $3 million. It was also credited with being the first to introduce Herbalife to Mexico. However, it was not until Sunday, August 11, 2011, that the body of Mr. Peterson was found dead in his truck that was parked at the residence west of the USA. Rail Birch, A2 Road Country, explained that it was Mr. Peterson who shot himself. Sometime later, some sources deduced that the complaints against the company and the failure to continue with his luxurious lifestyle led John Peterson to make this decision. Before authorities confirmed Mr. Peterson's suicide, Michael Johnson, the chief executive of Herbalife, released a statement saying that John Peterson had died in an accident inside his home. Finally, after learning the true cause of his death,
finalmente, después de saber la verdadera causa de su fallecimiento, la empresa decidió no hacer más comentarios y explicaron que eran asuntos privados de la familia Peterson. Si quieres ver la investigación original de este caso, te dejo los enlaces directos en la descripción. El último caso ocurrió hace unos años, en el extremo sureste de México. En octubre del 2014, una joven de 28 años, llamada Lorena Peralta, originaria de Huixtla, Chiapas, México, perdió la vida en el hospital, y su padre aseguró que fue por el consumo riguroso de las malteadas Herbalife, que sirven para bajar de peso. Según la información por parte de diferentes medios de comunicación que dieron a conocer esta noticia, el martes 21 de octubre del 2014, Lorena Peralta Baltazar falleció por la presencia de plomo en la sangre, al sur del estado de Chiapas. El padre de Lorena aseguró que ella había consumido malteadas Herbalife desde hace 6 meses atrás, y que días antes de su deceso, ella tuvo dolores fuertes, por lo que fue internada de urgencia en el hospital de Huixtla. Ante esto, el 28 de octubre del 2014, Herbalife emitió un reporte en su página oficial, donde explicaba a detalle por qué la empresa no tenía relación alguna con este incidente. Para empezar, mencionaron que las acusaciones se dieron a base del testimonio del padre de Lorena, quien aseguró que la muerte de la joven fue a causa de los productos de la empresa. Con este testimonio, algunos medios de comunicación declararon que el exceso de plomo por parte de los productos Herbalife fueron la causa de la muerte de Lorena. Sin embargo, la compañía explicó que la verdadera causa de su muerte fue por una
And in this way, Herbalife went unpunished for the accusations against it and continued his sales in Mexico. If you want to see some testimonies of this case, you can find the direct links in the description. With more than 35 years of experience in the nutrition industry, Herbalife is present in much of the planet today. Now that you know the secrets of Herbalife, I would like to know your opinion. What do you think of the case of Lorena Peralta? Thank you.